Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So this time you have a table called targets and you have some columns: product, start date, end date, start target and end target. So if you see, for each and every product you have a start date and end date, and start target and end target. So for the first row you have product 100, start date is on Jan 1st and end date is on Jan 10. And start target is 100 and end target is 10. So the output you need to create is, for every day between Jan 1st and Jan 10, you have to fix the target based on the start target and end target. Assume that there is a linear line between Jan 1st and Jan 10 based on the targets start target is 100 and end target is 10. So that is example. So here if you see, for product 100, on Jan 1st the target is 100 because this is the starting date and the target is 100, and on Jan 10th the target is 10 because this is the last date and this is the end target. And if you see, if you have to create a linear line between this start date and end date based on these targets, you need to calculate daily targets. So Jan 2nd is 100, Jan 2nd becomes 90, Jan 3rd becomes 80, Jan 4th becomes 70, Jan 5 60, Jan 6 50, so, like that. If you plot these targets on y-axis and these dates on x-axis, you will find a linear line. Okay, so that's what, this is the input, and you need to, based on the linear line, you need to create daily targets for every day between the start date and end date. So hope you understood the question. So now let's see how to approach this. So the approach is, first thing, you need to create a recursive CTE to fetch all the dates between the start date and end date for all products. So as you have seen earlier, so the starting Jan 1st and Jan 10, you have two dates, but you need some way to produce all the dates, Jan 2nd, Jan 3rd, Jan 4th and all till Jan 10. So you can use a recursive CTE to fetch all the dates between the start date and end date for each and every product. And next thing is, you need to calculate the daily increase or decrease value that has to be subtracted from the start target. So earlier you have seen, from 100 we are subtracting the values, like from 100 to 10, if you need to draw a line from 100 to 10, you need to subtract the values. So we need to have a formula that will calculate the daily targets. So the formula is the start target minus day difference of the start date and the current date. Suppose if it is Jan 5th, so start date is Jan 1st, right? So day difference between Jan 1st and Jan 5th multiplied by start target minus end target. Start target is 100 and end target is 10. 100 minus 10 is 90, divided by day difference between start date and end date. Start date is Jan 1st and end date is Jan 10th. So difference is 9 days. Okay, this way you will calculate the daily targets. So let's see an example. So for the first row, product 100, daily target on Jan 2nd. So if you see, Jan 1st is the start date and Jan 10th is the end date. And the start target is 100 and end target is 10. So the daily target on Jan 2nd is, if you see, start target, it is 100 minus day difference between start date and current date. So current date here in this case is Jan 2nd, right? So Jan 1st minus Jan 2nd, how many days you will get? One day you will get. Multiplied by start target minus end target, which is 100 minus 10. So it is 90, divided by day difference between start date and end date. Start date is Jan 1st and end date is Jan 10, which is 9 days. So 90 divided by 9, which is 10, and this is 1. So 100 minus 1 into 10, which is 90. So the daily target on Jan 2nd is 90. Next example, for the same row, let's see the daily target on Jan 5th. So again, here is the same formula. So start target is 100 minus date difference between start date and current date, which is Jan 5th minus Jan 1st. So you'll get 4 days, multiplied by start target minus end target, 100 minus 10, divided by day difference between start date and end date, Jan 10 minus Jan 1. So 100 minus 10 is 90, divided by Jan 10 minus Jan 1, which is 9. So this entire value is 90 divided by 9, 10. So 100 minus Jan 5 minus Jan 1 is 4 days. So 100 minus 4 into 10, which is 100 minus 40. So it is 60. So in this way, using SQL, you need to calculate the daily targets for each and every product. So there might be scenarios where the start target is always greater than end target. There might be scenarios where the start target is less than end target also. So you have one of the ID. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this using SQL. So as discussed, this is the targets table. You have this schemas, product, start date, end date, start target and end target. So this is the input. So as discussed, we have discussed this first row, which is start date is Jan 1st and end date is Jan 10, and start target is 100 and end target is 10. So if you see in all these three scenarios, the start target is always greater than the ending target. Because so in the last scenario, the start target is the less than the end target. So let's see whether this is the formula. Let's see how to derive this daily targets for each and every product between this each and every date. So as discussed, first we need to create a recursive CTE. So first is select from targets, and here it is product ID, comma, start date as date, comma, end date. Okay, and so let's run this. Invalid column product ID. Why is it invalid? So it is just a product, not product ID. Okay, so let's keep this in CTE with CTE as, and this is the anchor. So we all know for recursive CTE, you need to have an anchor query, and based on the anchor query, we'll be deriving the next set of data. So this is the anchor query. Basic data, basic table is the anchor query. And next, union all, and select from CTE, and here product is same, and the start date here, we'll make sure that this date column gets incremented. So how do we increment the date column? We have to use the date add function. Date add of day, comma, one day we'll have to add to the date, comma, end date. So now let's run this and see if we are getting properly. We need to add a breaking condition as well. So now let's see, because if we do not add a breaking condition, the CTE keeps on executing. So we need to add a breaking condition. So obviously this statement will be failed because we did not add a breaking condition. So if you see the output, so and you are getting a lot of rows and lot of dates. So the breaking condition is where this particular date column is less than end date. So we need to make sure we need to get the dates only from the dates between the start date and the end date. So this date column should always be less than end date. You cannot have a date column which is greater than end date, right? So that's why we'll have to add this condition. So now let's see. So okay, let's do an order by and see. Order by 1, 2. So if you do an one order by 1, 2, so for product 100, Jan 1st to Jan 10. So you are getting all the dates. So Jan 1st, Jan 2nd, 3rd, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All the dates you are getting. Okay. Again, here for the same product ID 100, you are having one more row, which is from Jan 10 to Jan 19, right? So from Jan 10 to Jan 19, again, you are getting all the rows. In same way, for other products also, you are getting all the rows. So now the first part of the query is successful. We have received the all the days between the start date and end date. And now it's time to apply the formula here. So select star from CTE, and so let's add the target also here, so that start target and end target. Okay, and let's do the same here also. I'm doing this here because otherwise we need to join the targets table again and get it. So instead of that, we can directly do it here. So what I'll do now, so let's apply the formula here. No, select star from CTE, and we want product, comma, date, comma, end date. We also, in this formula, if you see, we require a start date as well. A start date also, but we in this output you do not have a start date. So I'll add here the start date, and here also I'll add start date. Okay, So end date, sorry, the product date comma end date. I'll add the start date also here, start date comma end date. And now we have to calculate the formula. You have to apply the formula here. So the formula here is start target. So start target minus first is date difference between start date and current date. So date diff, we have to use the date diff function. It's date diff of we have to get in days comma start date is which is the start date. So current, I mean the, we have a start date, right? So start date comma date is nothing but the current date. So we have calculated the date difference, and now we have to multiply the start target minus and into multiply it by start target minus end target. Okay, and you have to divide by again date diff of start date comma end date. Okay, so now we have calculated, you have applied the formula, but some error we are getting. Let's see if it's working fine. Date different function requires three arguments. Okay, so we have to use the get it in day. So now let's see if we are getting the correct output. Okay, we are getting in decimals, so let's not get decimals. Let's convert it to integer. Okay, and let's use an order by 1 comma 2, so that we'll get the required output. So yeah, now we have received some output here. Let's verify if the output is correct. So for first row, for the 100, first row here input Jan 1st to Jan 10, and start target is 100 and end target is 10. So 100, 90, 80, 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20 and 10. So this is fine. This is the way we have discussed. And now again, let's see for this one. 200 Jan 1st to Jan 31st, 700 minus 700 to 100. So 700, 680, 660, 640, it is going on till you get the 100. Okay, so if you apply this, if you are able to get this formula correctly, writing this SQL part is very simple. It's just that you need to understand how to derive this formula. So here it is basic max. So we have studied y is equal to mx plus c. The same formula, same thing you have to apply here as well. So here if you see the start target and end target, start target is less than end target. So here the daily output should, I mean the daily target should increase. So 1200 to 2300, right? So 1200, 1300, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it is increasing. That means this formula is working fine. So in this way, we will have to calculate the daily targets. So hope you all like this question and also the solution. So if you like this, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.